Hello everyone. Welcome to today's live broadcast, Esports Ingredients, the competitive advantage you can feel working. I'm Jennifer Grebo, Editor-in-Chief of Nutritional Outlook, and I'll be your moderator for this event. We are pleased to bring you this session, the first session of our Spring 2002 Condition-Specific Symposium presented by Nutritional Outlook. Again, just a reminder, you can register for all the sessions for this virtual symposium using the link that's available in the resources section on the right-hand side of your screen. This session is sponsored by Sibelius Natural Products. I'd now like to read a message from our sponsor. Supporting wellness with plant-based ingredients, Sibelius takes traditionally used ingredients and provides the scientific evidence and clinical validation to support a number of consumer need states. The company believes that natural ingredients can make a great contribution towards healthy aging. This is why they are constantly invested in building modern scientific evidence behind well-known botanicals, helping their partners as well as consumers to make informed decisions. Using its proprietary ChronoScreen platform, Sibelius takes a science-led approach to uncovering the potential and providing insights on the impact of natural ingredients on age-related conditions. We have a few important announcements before we begin. First, we encourage you to go to the resources section of our platform on the right-hand side of your screen. There you can find resources from our sponsors. You can also use the link there to sign up for the other sessions in this event. This webcast is designed to be interactive, and we encourage you to ask questions during the event. You can submit questions by typing them in the Q&A box, which can be found on the right-hand side of your screen. We will answer all questions at the end of today's session. Please include the speaker's name if you are addressing your question to a specific speaker. You can enlarge the slide window by clicking on the small square icon in the upper right-hand corner of the slide window, or by hovering your mouse over the lower right-hand corner and dragging the window to the desired size. The slides will advance automatically during the event. If you have any technical problems hearing or viewing this presentation, please click on the question mark help widget in the dock at the bottom of your presentation window. I'd now like to introduce today's speakers. We are pleased to be joined today by Dr. Kieran Edwards and David Foreman. Kieran Edwards is the Chief Scientific Officer for Sibelius Natural Products. After completing his PhD in plant genetics, Kieran gained over 10 years' experience of biological research in academic and industrial settings. Over this time, he has used genetics, genomics, transcriptomics, and other systems approaches to investigate the regulation of physiological and biochemical traits in biological systems. In addition to his scientific training, Dr. Edwards completed his MBA at the University of Cambridge. David Foreman is a pharmacist, naturopath, author, speaker, and media personality known internationally as the Herbal Pharmacist. His background in pharmacy and natural medicine puts David in an elite class of health experts. Dave is highly sought after for his abilities as a science engineer, connecting the science world with sales, marketing, and consumers. Dave is a graduate of the University of South Carolina College of Pharmacy and the author of hundreds of articles and dozens of books, including Four Pillars of Health, Heart Disease, and Life Begins in the Gut. Kieran, Dave, thank you both for joining us today. Please get us started.
Thank you very much for having us. Well, hello everyone, and also thank you much for the introduction to Sibelius. I'll touch a little bit more about Sibelius, who we are and what we're about, before we dig into the science specifically related to the esports topic. But as you mentioned earlier, we're really about developing natural products, natural ingredients, which have got clinical backing, supporting beneficial effects that really will help to meet consumers' needs. And we place a real focus on selecting our ingredients from particular sources. And, you know, there's an emphasis on traceability and quality control there. And we want to make sure that we're going to get robust products and the consumer's going to get the benefits time on time. So we're careful about selecting the sources we go from so we can provide the same ingredient time on time and the same benefit time on time. And a big part about delivering this is our patented ChronoScreen platform that really helps us try and select the right sources, the right ingredients from the right sources to develop into products at the end of the day. And a big part of that screen is using a lifespan assay, which we think is very useful to try and help translate beneficial effects in terms of aging and age-related benefits. Because we know age is this major risk factor for so many human diseases and conditions. So we use that as a screen to help us select our ingredients. But a lot of these benefits will manifest themselves in a way which are, you know, not just to help you age better, but will also give you experiential benefits more immediately from that. So yeah, I guess, David, did you want to touch on what consumers are looking for then?
I'd be glad to take the reins from you, Karen. Thank you very much. And thanks to Nutritional Outlook for being able to put these types of events on. It's always a pleasure to be a part of any of the content that Nutritional Outlook provides. So the topic we're covering today is regarding esports, e-gaming, and what really are consumers looking for. I recently attended a sports and active nutrition summit, and esports was a good portion of it. I think sometimes as R&D, sales and marketing people, we don't think of playing a game on a computer or on your phone as a sport. But trust me, there are people making millions of dollars now doing this. And then, of course, the people that are just doing it for their own enjoyment. They're looking for several things. Probably the biggest of all of these is really to get that memory enhancement, improved ability to have improved reaction times, et cetera. But because of the wear and tear of their hands, they're also looking for things to support joint health or joint discomfort. Being able to stay attentive and focus while they're playing their game. We are all, if you're watching this, you're probably exposed to blue light, so eye health is a major concern moving forward. And then the last two at the bottom, sleep and recovery and relaxation. So one of the things I've actually observed about gamers is not only do gamers want to be like, you know, kind of super hyper-focused and have great reaction times, but at the same time, there needs to be this sense of calm and relaxation while they're doing it. They don't want to be nervous or jittery. And then last but not least, especially for professional gamers, they might be practicing or playing a game for 8 to 10 hours at some time. And even those people that do it casually for maybe 3 or 4, the biggest issue they seem to have after the game is being able to wind down and get to sleep. And so these are the areas that gamers are looking for. In all honesty, I feel like any of us in an active lifestyle, I think we're all looking for these. So maybe not just necessarily esports and e-gaming specific with the conversation we're having today. Moving along, these are some of the numbers behind the industry. The digital category is really evolving right now. I was on a call with a company in Poland a couple weeks ago, and they're looking at really this market is being beyond gaming and esports, but really in just this whole digital marketplace. And you can see global esports revenues are expected to grow significantly, 14.5% annual growth rates. Top esports industry growth drivers are really because of social distancing. We know the last several years that's been a big part of life. And you know, it's funny, even though that seems to have come to an end in most areas around the world, I still run into an awful lot of people that are still wanting to keep their distance, which in my opinion is really not that bad of an idea. There was a study that found that screen times have actually increased by 70% during COVID. And then, again, like I said earlier, the effectiveness of brain supplements are a key area of concern, especially in consumers that are participating in e-games and e-sports. And with regards to our talk today, this is Sibelius-centric today. There's two primary ingredients, and actually, in all honesty, I'd actually add a third that we're not going to talk about into this, but are Sibelius sage and Sibelius chamomile. Sibelius sage, no pun intended, focuses on the ability to help support memory, focus, attention, alertness, recall, your mental acuity. These are all important things for people that have an active lifestyle, in this case for gaming. The cool thing about this, and I'll throw it in right now, and Kieran will get more into the science behind these ingredients, but is really the fact that Sibelius sage provides your brain with what I call this experiential ability to concentrate and focus, without getting nervous or jittery. And that was one of the biggest complaints that I've also heard from the active nutrition summit that I attended, was that these gamers want to stay sharp. They want to have that extra vibe mentally, but at the same time, they don't need to be nervous or jittery because they might not hit the A key when they're supposed to, or hit something, you know, completely different. And then, of course, the whole calming, staying calm, being able to stay calm and focused, and then at the end of your gaming sector, be able to actually get to sleep and have a good, peaceful, restful sleep. And with Sibelius chamomile, there's actually more benefits. I think a lot of us are familiar with chamomile. Most of us are probably familiar with German. This is completely different. This is Roman chamomile. And there's some very strong effects that have been shown to help reduce the inflammatory response that occurs in the body. And starting out with both these ingredients, we can see that consumers, I think, have pill fatigue. I know I do. If you saw my kitchen cabinet where I keep my supplements, pill fatigue is an issue. Well, these ingredients are functional in whatever format you really want to use. So if you're looking at drinks, whether it's a shot or a full beverage, gels, gummies, powders. Actually, I have a Sibelius Sage powder sitting right here on my desk. Chocolate bars, you name it. There are many different ways to go about this, and Sibelius even provides assistance through them to help you with your formulating challenges and needs. They will actually help walk you through that process. And then I'll just get into the quick intro on Sibelius Sage, because this is really how I became familiar with Sibelius as the company, was because of Sage. I learned about it 4 years ago attending a lunch and learn, and fell in love with it right away. Again, this is a proprietary sage. It's patented and clinically proven. Kieran will get into the clinical side of this. Probably my favorite response I get from people when I've given them some to try is that it's fast acting. The clinical study shows that it, you know, does work within an hour. The majority of the people, including myself, that take it in a glass of water or just a stick pack in my mouth and then chase it with a little water, I can feel it usually work in 20 to 30 minutes if I haven't had anything to eat. So again, consumers are loving it, clinically proven benefits. And again, it helps to promote that attention alertness without that buzzy caffeine thing that again, especially gamers are not looking forward to. And somebody like me who's had issues with blood pressure in the past, the last thing I need is something to give my cardiovascular system a little extra constriction. So Sibelius Sage is a great way to go. And I will turn it over to Kieran, who's going to get into more of the science behind these two amazing ingredients.
Thank you very much, David. Yeah, and just, you know, to reiterate the point there, you know, we're talking about Sibelius Sage here, so it's you know, old English sage kind of stuff you can buy in your supermarket. But bear in mind that, you know, we've taken a lot of care about selecting a very specific source. So we've got a differentiated source of sage, and as David mentioned, patent protecting that source. And all the data we generate is then linked back to this specific source we've got. And as part of our process, we really try and understand the science of what's going on with our ingredients. We don't want to just take an ingredient and say, oh, well, people think this is good for condition X, Y, or Z. We want to look into it and really understand what is happening. And that's where our ChronoScreen approach comes in. And as part of that process for the sage, as well as picking a good source, we've gone on and sort of looked at what kind of activities it is having. And particularly around the areas of memory and focus and attention and even risk-taking, as you can see on the slide here, these are areas where the sage is having activities that could translate through to benefits in terms of people's gaming performance. As David mentioned as well, and as you mentioned already, David, as well, not just gamers, but generally all of us could get benefits from this area. But given the topic of this webinar, I think it's worth framing things in that context. And a big part in these three areas of memory, focus, attention, and risk-taking really comes down to the effects that we're seeing that the sage extract has, particularly on neurotransmitters. So the chemicals that are going through our brains, helping connect neurons to each other and helping our mental performance occur. Now, there's a history with sage known to have cholinergic effects, and in particular, this helps to maintain higher levels of the acetylcholine neurotransmitters. And these are very important neurotransmitters from the perspective of memory. performance. And indeed, what we can see is that the SAGE is inhibiting the activity of enzymes, the same enzymes being targeted by drugs that are used in the treatment of Alzheimer's disease, for instance, to help maintain higher levels of acetylcholine and really try and maximize the signaling between the network of neurons in our brain as much as possible, given that, you know, diseases like Alzheimer's, that is being degraded, that network. So we've got activities on there. What we're also now seeing, particularly with the SAGE, is that there seems to be growing support for effects on other neurotransmitters, and in particular dopamine and serotonin, for instance. And these are often kind of considered the feel-good hormones. And it's worth sort of noting, though, that dopamine has particular relevance to focus and attention and cognitive flexibility. Similarly, it influences our risk attitude. So having the right balance of our neurotransmitters is going to play into a lot of these areas and improve our performance across from memory to focus and attention and risk attitude, which obviously we can see how that may be beneficial to someone who's playing e-games at an elite level. Taking that on there, you know, we've got these immediate benefits, and as David mentioned, we're near immediate benefits in terms of cognitive performance, and we'll dig into that for some of the clinical support of that in a second. But longer term as well, we think there's benefits likely to come from the SAGE through these anti-inflammatory effects, where we know that inflammation is not good in terms of our cognitive performance. So higher levels of inflammation tend to be inversely correlated to our cognitive abilities, particularly linked with aging there. And that translates through in multiple ways. For instance, even helping to maintain the elasticity of our vasculature to help maintain blood flow to our brain to supply the oxygen and glucose that our brain needs in order to perform all these functions. So we know across all these different areas that the kind of activities that SAGE is having, and clearly how this translates in terms of benefits to the consumer. So we've done a couple of studies in people where we've got them to take the SAGE. The first one was done in healthy older adults, and this was a crossover study where essentially the people were given four different active doses of the SAGE versus a placebo, and they took all the different doses with a seven-day washout between the visits, obviously with the order randomized, so they didn't know what treatment they were taking at any time. And during each visit, they essentially took a baseline test where they were doing multiple different tasks, computer-based tasks, that were assessing their cognitive abilities in multiple ways. Not quite, you know, gaming, but you know, elements of there which are going to be relevant to gaming, testing their recognition and recall of images and words, but also their reaction times, etc., being tested at multiple times throughout the visit once they've been given the treatment. So they're tested at a baseline level and then tested again 1 hour, 2.5 hours, 4 hours, and 6 hours after treatment. So we can really see the timing of these effects coming into it when we look at the data. And in this study, there was two key areas where we saw real benefits emerging from taking the SAGE supplement. And what we can see these on these two panels on the left here. So panel A is looking at a feature of our cognitive abilities, which is called secondary memory. So this is all about the ability to embed memory, slightly longer term memory. It's not your working memory where you're holding a piece of information actively in your mind and doing tasks. And this is where you've embedded it to be able to recall it at a later point. And what you can see here is that the different time points on our x-axis showing the 1 hour, 2.5, 4, and 6 hours, and then on the y-axis is how their performance on these elements across those tasks has changed versus their baseline performance at zero. And at our 333 milligram dose of SAGE in these black triangles, which are highlighted in the blue circle there, you can see that the performance remains relatively flat over that period of time, but it's significantly better than the placebo treatment in the open circles, which is showing about a 30 to 40% reduction in performance compared to baseline. Now, this kind of reduction compared to baseline has been seen in multiple studies now. Maybe this relates to the fact that, you know, these are quite intensive tasks that these people are being asked to do on the computer battery of tests. So it probably plays into things like fatigue, et cetera, influencing their performance and knocking it down, which obviously, when you're thinking about from an e-game perspective, to be able to maintain a good level of performance throughout there and not suffer from fatigue, to have that mental energy and mental endurance to keep performing on there, clearly would be a real benefit to it. We can see in the other panel there, panel B, we're looking at here accuracy and speed of attention. So this is very much more related to the ability to focus on a particular task at hand, as opposed to being influenced and you know, put off and missing opportunities there because you're not focusing on what you should be doing. And you can see again that 333 milligram dose of SAGE has got a significant improvement at all time points compared to the placebo treatment. And just to reiterate here, this is the guys taking a single dose and getting a response on these features within an hour of taking it. So, you know, very nice to see that data in older adults. Obviously, probably the typical demographic of esports is going to be slightly less than 65. So thankfully, we've also done studies in younger adults as well. So we've looked in 18 to 25-year-olds. Very similar study going on here, except instead of doing a crossover study where everyone took all doses, we just did a parallel study where individuals are either taking a placebo or one of two doses of the SAGE and then doing these computer-based tasks, this time just at 1 and 2.5 hours post-taking it. And again, you can see in a task of secondary memory, for instance here, we get improvements around about that 30% uplift in performance through taking, in this case, both doses of SAGE, 150 and a 300 milligram dose of SAGE, showed improvements over the placebo. So again, we're looking on our x-axis baseline versus 1 hour and 2.5 hours post versus the change to baseline over that period of time. You can see the placebo falls off sharply by an hour. It bounces back and recovers, whereas our two SAGE doses remain flat throughout the whole period again. So, you know, you can really see how you're not going to get that fatigue, that fall off happening through taking the SAGE. It's really going to help us out in terms of performing, you know, being at a maximal performance cognitively throughout these kind of tasks. In terms of the features there, you know, we're talking about aqueous ethanolic extract. So really, we're trying to get as much of the biochemistry that's present in our SAGE leaf out as much as possible into the ingredient. It's standardized, though, so we've got at least, you know, 2.5% rosmic acid levels. There's a herbal flavor, but that's easily mastered. You know, David alluded to, we want to make sure that the, you know, people aren't suffering from pill fatigue. And I can speak, having seen David's bag of pills, that, you know, he could suffer from pill fatigue very easily. But, you know, so having the different formats is very useful in there. And, you know, we've tested this in multiple age groups now and seeing beneficial effects there. Obviously, shelf life is important from an ingredient perspective, so it's a very stable ingredient. So you can see this all plays into having sorry, David, you wanted to jump in, did you?
Yeah. First, I want to thank you for abusing me for the amount of pills I do take, and that was wonderful. But it keeps me looking young and sharp, at, you know, even though I'm 85. So, but no, one thing I really want to draw out for the people that are attending this today, to me, is, you know, other than it's clinically proven to work, is the fact that it's very fast acting. And in this time and you know, that we're in, I feel like you know, people want to know it's something's working. You want to be able to feel it working. If I take my vitamin D3, I can't feel it working. I have to get blood work. But in this case, you know, a clinical study showed that in the first hour. So let's say I'm not a regular gamer. I don't have a special, like, time. I do it every day. I mean, that's the way my golf team is. I go out and play when I'm ready to play. In this case, if you're going to sit down to play a game, or in my case, I'm getting ready to do a webinar, I know I can take my dose of Sibelius SAGE, and that within that hour, in my case, it's usually 20 to 30 minutes, I'm going to already start feeling the effect. And so for us that are trying to get products in the hands of consumers and have them rebuy them, having something that's experiential, they can feel working, and we know that feeling or ability to work is going to happen in the first hour. That bodes well for you as a company putting out a very reputable product.
Yeah, definitely. Very good point. Thank you for raising it. So we touched on, you know, the that kind of being switched on without being jittery point being important, you know, having that you know, focus, alertness, speed reaction time, memory being very important features for from an e-gaming perspective. But also we touched on the fact earlier, David, that you want to be calm and also be able to switch off afterwards being very important process. So I'll touch very quickly on another of our ingredients which you introduced, which is Sibelius chamomile. And again, just to reiterate, we're talking Roman chamomile here. A lot of chamomile on the market is going to be German chamomile. So there are some similarities between the two, but we've picked a very specific source of Roman chamomile. And, I touched on the benefits of inflammation being negatively related to cognitive performance previously. What we're seeing with our chamomile extract is very nice strong activities in terms of anti-inflammatory effects from the research we've been doing. So we're very excited to see how it develops in that area and whether there could be some long-term benefits there in terms of cognitive performance as well as multiple other areas of health. But another area where chamomile has kind of traditionally been used is all about relaxation and sleep as key components there. So we've got this very specific source of Roman chamomile. Again, we're looking here at an aqueous ethanol extract, but in this case, it's a tincture. We are working on a powder for the future, but right now we're looking at a tincture in this. And it really is playing into areas of helping maintain a restful sleep, all about kind of balance, serenity and balance. So that kind of anxiolytic effects really preventing anxiety, being calm and focused. So you can see our combination of those two features from the sage and from the chamomile are really the kind of sweet spot that you'd be looking for. There's other benefits there around smooth muscle relaxation. So, I think particularly there you might be thinking about sort of digestive discomfort, et cetera, playing in as well. Probably maybe less relevant to e-gaming specifically, but maybe of interest as well. But general wellness and immunity coming through from these anti-inflammatory effects. And it's, as I mentioned, it's a tincture, so it's a 1.2 mil daily dose of this, whereas with the sage, we saw a 333 milligram dose of the powder. For the chamomile, again, traceable source, we've got it standardized to a total phenolic level. Herbal flavor in there, but again, easily masked, and again, a nice long shelf life on that. And I think, clearly, we're talking about a few different ingredients here where there's going to be benefits that can play into the area of e-gaming. And if you want more information, then please do visit our website where you can get white papers, samples, cell sheets, et cetera, and further information on there. And please do get in contact with us.
So I want to add, David,
do you want to wrap any other comments, David?
Yeah, actually, I want to make a comment on the chamomile. One of the things that you pointed out was this ability to relax smooth muscle. And it's funny because you said it might not be relevant for gamers, but it's funny when I know people that do game for a long period of time, especially if they are consuming some of the beverages and some of the foods they consume actually are upsetting to the stomach. And the last thing you need is to have that cramping or gastric, blah feeling. We all know what that is, right? So by being able to calm down the smooth muscle, which the whole gastrointestinal tract is smooth muscle, I feel like this would be something that would provide even a benefit to gamers. And then, of course, as long as we can talk outside the gaming thing for right now, that whole ability to relax smooth muscle bodes well for women's health, especially for women who have issues with like menstrual cramps. People have respiratory problems because bronchioles are smooth muscle as well. So lots of other applications outside. But I just wanted to throw that in because I feel like other than the calm and being able to sleep, I think it does provide other benefits to gamers as well.
No, it's a very good point. Yeah, thanks for raising it.
My pleasure.
Thank you for listening in, guys, and I hope you found it useful.
Yeah, and Dave, thank you so much for that great presentation. And Dave, I do want to see that bag of pills of yours one day.
I'd be embarrassed. Maybe I'll take a picture and put it on my LinkedIn, but I might be embarrassed.
We know how healthy you are.
It actually makes me look like a drug addict with all the colored pills, to be honest with you. So, but just knowing that there's not a drug in the bag and it's all I am a product of the industry. I can tell you that, Jen. When it comes to supplements, I practice what I preach, and I'd say 98% of my diet is what I preach. So yeah, it's, there's nothing worse than a hypocrite in the industry, right?
Yeah, well, we love it. So, great, both of you. Before we get started on the question and answer session, I'd just like to remind our audience how you can submit questions. You can submit questions by typing them in the Q&A box, which again can be found on the right-hand side of the presentation window. So let's go to our first question. Okay, Dave, you started talking a little bit about an experiential supplement. Can you talk a little bit more about that?
Yeah, you know what's kind of sad, Jennifer, is that I was told as a child that you never used the word in a definition, but I'm going to have to. experiential means I can experience it. I can feel something happening to my body. So, you know, people understand if I drink caffeine, you know, you might feel nervous or jittery. In the case of Sibelius Sage, you just feel this. I associate it with like this electricity in a positive way, just kind of helping my brain fire off in a great positive way. And then even with the chamomile, that's experiential because, you know, if you take enough of it, you will feel the calmness that, you know, when you take it, and, you know, help you relax to get to sleep. So it's just being able to feel something working. As opposed to just trusting that it's worked. You know, if we take an immune supplement, do we know it's working or not? No, we don't, because we can't feel it working. But in this case, anything experiential means I can feel it in a certain amount of time.
Right, and those are benefits so key, especially for this market that we're talking about today. Another question. So, you know, they began touching on this, but with pills fatigue, can Sage be incorporated in different formats? Can you talk a little bit more, elaborate on that?
Yeah, sure, of course. So and as you said, it's a powdered extract, but you know, it is very much amenable to multiple different formats. You can take it in sort of a standard dietary supplement, you know, capsule format, but we have a powdered version which goes very well into drinks, and I've tried a number of different drinks with very nice flavors actually where sage has been incorporated. I really felt some, you know, those experiential effects come through very well in those liquid formats, I find. We've also got them in jellies. People talk about putting them in chocolate. So, yeah, very much a case that it can be put in multiple different formats so we can get away from that issue of the pill fatigue.
Perfect. Okay, that was great. And another question, we have time for one more. You know, we talked about how a lot of consumers like to feel the immediate benefits of what they're taking. But, you know, we'd also hope that they would look forward at, you know, the longer view. So what are some of the long-term benefits of these solutions that you have presented today?
Very good question there. Clearly, you know, the ultimate is to have a little bit of both, so you can get those near immediate beneficial effects that the consumer can feel, so they're going to come back and reuse it, but equally you can improve their health in the long run by taking it. And I suppose, you know, in terms of the two products we've touched on today, both the sage and the chamomile, we've got data there supporting some nice anti-inflammatory effects, and there's obviously both of these botanicals have been linked to anti-inflammatory effects in terms of traditional uses. And we've got some really nice data on our sources showing nice, strong anti-inflammatory effects playing through. And I kind of touched on it earlier, but just to delve into it a little bit deeper in response to this question, inflammation is this really major factor that is having multiple negative effects on multiple aspects of our health. And that ranges through from cardiovascular disease through to, you know, even cancer, metabolic disease as well. But in relation to what we're talking about here in terms of the cognitive side of things, clearly there's the negative effects of inflammation on our cognitive performance of aging. So we would hope that you'd get benefits through in terms of cognition, but obviously these other areas as well playing through out of longer term taking of these supplements. I mentioned it earlier, potentially helping to fight atherosclerosis and maintain cerebral blood flow, so we get that nice healthy flow of blood to the brain, for instance. So I think, you know, tying the two together, those short-term experiential benefits that really let you know something's happening, tied through to longer anti-inflammatory benefits, it's a nice combination to have from these products.
And I'd like to add on to that, too, if you don't mind, Kieran and Jennifer. You know, years ago, I trademarked the herbal pharmacist, and you know, the majority of my career has been more in the botanical space. Granted, I know about, you know, pretty much all of the ingredients that we have in the industry. But the added benefit to a botanical is sort of the point that's behind what Kieran was just speaking. We are learning more and more about plants and the phytochemical compounds and being in the right ratios, but there's not just these, you know, one single entity within a plant. There's nutritional components, vitamins, minerals, there's fats, proteins, carbohydrates. And then in plants, there's just not one phytochemical, there's many. And that's why we're now decoding so many plant extracts that have multiple, in some cases, like a 10 or more mechanisms of action and how they work in the body. And that's why using botanicals long-term tend to be more like a tonic supporting the health of the body as opposed to stimulating it to do one thing or another.
Yeah, that's a very good point.
Absolutely. Thank you both for that. Such a great talk, just so much great information for such a relevant concern and category for the market today. I think that is all the time we have for questions today. So we're going to wrap it up here. But again, Kieran, Dave, thank you for being here today, sharing your expertise. I want to thank the audience for attending and participating in this session of the Nutritional Outlook Spring 2022 Condition Specific Symposium. All other questions will be answered offline. As a reminder, you can sign up for all the sessions in this event using the link available in the resources section on the right-hand side of your screen. Our next session will be held at 2 p.m. Eastern Time. We'd also like to ask everyone in the audience to participate in a brief survey. You can see the survey to the right of your screen. And finally, I'd like to thank our sponsor, Sibelius Natural Products, for making this event possible. We want to remind you to take advantage of the resources again from the sponsor, which you can find on the right-hand side of your screen, and we will send you a notification when the recording of this session is ready. Thank you all for joining, and we will see you next time. Goodbye.